subtraction. So for that we have to know the rules for binary subtraction also. So these are some rules for binary subtraction. So zero minus, no, you can note down parallelly in your notes. So binary subtraction, 0 minus 0 equals to 0, 1 minus 0 equals to 1, 1 minus 1 will be by default 0, 0 minus 1 means there will be a borrow. Okay, so let me go for example. Let me take 4 minus 2. Let me take an example, 4 minus 2. 4 in binary equivalent will be 0, 1, 0, 0. And 2 in binary equivalent will be 0, 0, 1, 0. Now we have to perform binary subtraction. So in binary subtraction, what are the rules that we have just now seen is 0 minus 0 equals to 0. 0 minus 1 equals to, we need to go for a borrow. We need to go for a borrow. Next, 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0 will be 1. Next, 1 minus 1 will be 0. Okay. Now, let us start with this LSB part. 0 minus 0 will be 0. 0 minus 1, what we have to do, ma? We have to go for a borrow. So this will be cancelled and you will get here 0. And listen, all of you, it is very important to note down in your notes. Whenever there is a borrow in a binary representation, the borrow will be 2. Whenever there is a borrow in octal representation, the borrow will be 8. It will be based on the base. Whenever there is a borrow in hexadecimal representation, the borrow will be 16. The borrow will be 16. Here this will be 0. Here this will become 0, and this will, if you place 1 by default, 1 0 in binary representation will be 2. So 2 minus 1 you will get 1. Next, anyhow we left off with 0. 0 minus 0 based on this we will have 0. Next, 0 minus 0 will have 0. So finally what we got, the answer is 0010, which is equivalent to decimal number 2. So definitely we got the result 4 minus 2 equals to 2. Okay, so let me take another example. 9 minus 4. So 9 minus 4, 9 is represented in binary as 1, 0, 0, 1. And 4 is represented as 0, 1, 0, 0. So if you do subtraction based on the above rules, what will be? 1 minus 0 will be 1. Next is what? 0 minus 0 will be 0. Next, 0 minus 1, we need to go for a borrow. So this will become 0. This will become 2. 2 minus 1 will be 1. So you got 5. In this way, you have to do borrow. But let us consider, try to concentrate, ma. Why we are going for subtraction operations? Let us consider 1, 0, 0, 0, minus 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay, so what we are doing here, 0 minus 1, we have to go for a borrow, but next here also we have a 0 here also, so this will become 0. Now this will be 2. Okay, now again it has to pass to this, so this will become 1 now, and this will become 2. So again, if it has to pass, so it will become, this will become 2. So 2 minus 1 you will get 1. Next, 1 minus 1 you will get 0. 1 minus 0 you will get 1. 0 minus 0 you will get 0. Okay, so in this way you have to do. But what is happening in this, try to concentrate, the number of borrows are more. To overcome that, try to concentrate here. Whenever we are not doing subtractions in our designing circuits, we are converting those subtractions to complements. So try to concentrate here. Just now I have taken A as 4 and B as 2, and everyone knows that these two are operands and we are having an operator called minus. Okay, so whenever you are doing a minus b, we are converting this a minus b to a plus b with the help of complements. So what I am doing is, instead of writing a minus b, means instead of going where it goes, ma, actually if it is instruction is given in the in this way, a minus b, what happens? This a minus b from memory, it goes to processor. In processor, it goes to arithmetic and logical unit for performing the operation. So for this, it goes to subtraction. So subtraction logic will be there based on that. But what is happening in subtraction is the number of borrows involved, and the in order to design a circuit, it will be complicated. So to overcome that, with the help of a complement, what we are doing is we are converting that to B complement. So which one you have to do complement means the negative number. Try to concentrate, ma, here. So here it goes to arithmetic addition only. Even if it is subtraction, what operation we are doing? We are doing addition. But what modifications that we are doing in order to convert that to addition, subtraction to addition, is that we are going for negative number, we are representing in complement. Are you getting here? See, ma, this is your internal circuit for adder. You have, in order to perform internally addition, subtraction, all those, you have to design some logic gates. Given an input, like gates will be there, given an input, so output will be generated. This we will discuss in completely in second unit, but least bothered about that. You try to concentrate what is happening here. Why we are going for a complement is very important. So why we are going for a complement here is that, so we are converting this subtraction operation to addition with the help of complements. So the negative number here, negative number is A or B?
B,
it is B. So for that B, you have to represent in complement. So you are representing that with complement, and the complemented number plus A, if you add, you will get the result, negative result as 2. So let me start with the, what is the problem with subtraction? Why we are going for a complement is that, in a subtraction, whenever you are subtracting, for much of the cases, it will be like a borrows will be involved, more number of borrows will be involved. So designing a circuit will be complicated in this. To overcome that, what we are doing is, instead of doing subtraction, we are going for a complements. So let us start with the what are complements. So see here, this is your borrow. This, just now we have taken, this is one more example. So 1100 minus 1010. So in this case, 00 will be 0. 0 minus 1, you have to take a borrow. So borrow in this case, it is 10. So 10 minus 1, so you will get 1. Here left out is 0. 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. So the problem in this case is the number of borrows involved is more. To overcome that, we are going for a complements. We will see the signed numbers after completing. So complements. So if having any doubts, you try to unmute and you try to answer. You try to ask the questions. Why? Because this complements, how we are doing binary additions, why we are going for a binary subtraction, why we are implementing in complements. If you are having any doubts here, you need to concentrate more from this. So complements, subtraction of a number requires a different algorithms from that of addition. So adding the complement of a number is equivalent to subtraction. Just now I said, no? So in this, representation of complements will be done in two ways. So what are those two ways is, you try to see, ma'am. Complements of two numbers, there are, complementation can be done in two types. So one is R's complement and the other one is R minus 1's complement. So R's complement, we will be representing this as a radix complement. R minus 1 will be represented as diminished radix complement. So let me start with a R's complement, radix complement. So see here, note down this formula in your notes. Given a number N, try to concentrate. Given a number n here, in this capital N in base R having n digits, the R's complement of n is defined as, that's complement of n is defined as r power n minus n. So see here, in this case, we can arc, we already discussed about four different types of number systems. So in this, we have taken a decimal number system. So in this decimal number system, base will be 10. So here for decimal number system, the base or r is 10. So 10's complement of n is 10 power. Why we have written 10 is we are considering here number as decimal. So 10 power n minus 1. So n is what? I will show with an example so that you can understand clearly. Everyone noted the formula, right? What is the formula for what we are calculating now? We started binary subtraction over. So in order to represent binary subtraction, in same operation you want to do in addition is you are going for a complements. So complements can be represented in two ways. One is r's complement and the other one is r minus 1's complement. So now I am starting with r's complement. So in order to represent r's complement, we have to represent the formula. So what is the formula is r power small n minus capital N. Okay. So now let us consider, I want to calculate r's complement binary number. For binary number 1101, okay, so this will become what? Capital N. This is your digit, okay, this is your number N. So how many digits are present in this number? 1 2 3 4. How many are there? How many bits in a given number?
4.
Yes. So what happens? Small n will become 4. Now what will be r? Is it 10?
2.
Yes, it is 2. Why? Because we are representing in binary. So definitely in binary means the base will be 2. So you will have 2. So now you substitute those values. R is 2. 2 and the number of digits in a given number, we have 4 minus n. Minus n. N is this. 1101. So 1101. Now 2 power 4 is how much, ma?
16.
Huh?
16.
16. So 16 is not in a binary, it is in decimal. Try to concentrate. 16 is not in a binary, it is in decimal. So this is in binary. So in order to perform subtraction, what you have to do? You have to convert this, 16 to binary. So if you convert the 16 to binary, what you will get?
1000.
If having any doubts while explaining, you ask. Okay, minus 1101. Now do the subtraction and tell me the answer. Just now I have given how to do subtraction operation, right? So 1000 minus, can anyone tell me what is this number 1101? 1101 em number?
13.
Okay, 13. Ippudu cheyandi minus 1101. So starting, we have to start from borrow. So borrow means what you have to do? Directly you have to go here, you have to make this to 0, 2, again it will be 1, again this 2, it will be 1. Chepa name ochindi answer.
0001.
Is that answer is same? 16 minus 13 will be what? 3. Are we getting the answer? Yes. So here what I said just now, you try to complete. I will try to complete this one. So what will be the result? Now it is 2. 2 minus 1, you will get 1. 1 minus 0, you will get 1. 1 minus 1, you will get 0. 1 minus 1, you will get 0. This will be 0. So the answer is 0001. So if what we are doing here, 16 minus 13, you have to get the answer as 3. We got the answer 3. Okay. So, nenu em cheppanu just now, why we are going for a complement is in order to reduce borrows. But are we doing borrow? Again, we are encountering here borrows, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes. So, the solution for this is, first, let me explain this. So, first, if you start with R's complement, what is happening is, again, we are having a number of borrows or more. So, what I am doing is, let me start with R minus 1's complement. Now tell me how many number of we have a decimal, we have an octal, we have a hexadecimal, we have a binary. Now start. What will be the decimal representation base? R's complement. It is
10.
10's complement we need to calculate here. Coming to R minus 1 means what we have to calculate? R is 10 here, minus 1, what will get? 9's complement. Yes. Next. Octal, base?
8.
So, 8's complement we need to calculate here. R minus 1?
7.
7's complement. Next. Hexa?
16.
16's complement. R minus 1? Yes, ma. R minus 1?
15.
15 means, should I write 15 or what symbol I have to write here?
F.
F's complement. Next, coming to binary.
2.
We need to calculate here 2's complement. Here as 1's complement. Okay? So, try to concentrate here, ma. So, do we get R's complement if you add 1 to this? Yes, right? So, see here, 1's complement plus 1 equals to, we will get 2's complement. 1's complement plus 1 equals to 2's complement. Okay? So, we will start with R minus 1's complement. Why? Because if we start with R's complement, what is happening here? In this number of borrows, again the same issue happening. So, let me start with R minus 1's complement. Note down in your notes, ma. This I will ask you again. In decimal representation, R minus 1's will be 9's complement. In octal, it will be 7's complement. In hexa, it will be F's complement. In binary, it will be 1's complement. So, definitely in order to do these complements, first you have to do 9's complement plus 1, you will get 10's complement. 7's complement plus 1, you will get 8's complement. F's complement plus 1, you will get 16's complement. Okay? So, note down. So, let me start with, now I need to start which complement? My R's complement or R minus 1's complement?
R minus 1 complement.
Yes, R minus 1 complement. See here. R minus 1's complement. So, in R minus 1's complement, the formula here is, given a number n in base R having n digits, R minus 1's complement of n is defined as, see, R power n minus 1 minus n. Okay? So, here what I'm doing is, R minus 1's complement equals to, I'm writing as R power n minus n minus 1. Okay. So, can you tell me what is this formula? R power n minus n? Is it, this is what?
R's complement.
Yes, this is R's complement. So, I'm substituting this R's complement minus 1. Next, what I'm doing is R minus 1's complement plus 1 equals to, just now I said, if you calculate r minus 1's complement, if you add 1, what you will get just now I said? You will get r's complement. So I've kind of converted here. So here, r minus 1's complement, if you plus 1, if you, so what happens, just now I said that if you are doing 7's complement, if you're doing 7's complement, this is your 7's complement in octal, plus 1, you will get what? R's complement. So let me start with R's complement. You note down this, ma'am. R minus 1's complement equals to R bar n minus n minus 1. So this is nothing but, this representation is nothing but R's complement. So this is your R's complement minus 1. So if it's, if this 1 ends here, it will be plus 1. So R's complement plus 1 equals to R's complement. Okay. So now let me start with the example. So in this case, while calculating, you have to check again, are there any borrows involved? Okay. Our main intention is to make these, whatever the design circuit that we are designing for subtraction, the number of borrows should be reduced so that complexity will be reduced. So let me start with the example. Binary, I will take a same binary number or else a different binary number. 1101. Okay. Now, what is the formula? Na? R power n minus 1 minus n. Okay. So, what is R here?
2.
2. What is n, small n here?
4.
4. Why? 4. Because the number of digits in a given number, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, you will have 4. Minus 1 minus the number given mentioned here is 1101. So it is nothing but 16 minus 1 minus 1101. So 16 minus 1 is 15 minus 1101. Now tell me 15 representation in binary, ma'am.
Double one.
Minus 1101. What answer we will get?
Zero 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 one.
Okay. So this is your answer. Okay. Why? Because 15 minus what is this? So try to concentrate here. Listen here.
00 10 10 10 10.
Okay. Okay, 10. Okay. Now, whenever we are getting this one, you try to concentrate. This is our number. Okay. So this is our number, and when there is no need of doing all this. Simply given a number, if it is given as r minus 1's complement 1101, you have to subtract with 1111. Means for every case this will be common. Try to concentrate, ma. This will be common. So every time there is no need of calculating this. This will be common. Means if there are four digits in a given number, you will get 4 ones. If there are 5 digits in a given number, you will get 5 ones. If there are 3 digits in a given number, you will get 3 ones. So this is common. So there is no need of calculating again and again this rules. So by default, it will be 1's complement means what you will do. So you will start from here. You will start from here. This is also will be eliminated. Let me start. Let me explain. So this one is 1111 minus 1101. So if you do, what we will get? 0100. Okay, this is your answer. Manaku ikkadaina borrow ochindamma? Is there any complexity involved? No, right? Now, just now I said that in a binary representation, r minus 1's will be 1's complement. So 1's complement ante given any how many digits are there, those many 1's you will do. Now tell me the same in this 1's, if it is octal. చెప్పండి అమ్మా ఆక్టల్ కి ఇక్కడ 1 ఏం పెట్టుకోవాలి
777
yes 77 let me see whether we are getting 777 or not okay So until here, is it clear? Let me start with octal. Let me start with octal. The same formula, let me take the octal number. So that we have to get 7777 minus. Octal number 172. Okay, now tell me, what is n? 172. N equals to what? Small n? 3. Capital N? 172. R?
8.
Okay, so formula is R power n minus 1 minus n. So R is what? 8 power 3 minus 1 minus 172. Okay, so this part you have to get 3 sevens. Why 3 sevens? Why not 2 sevens? Means number of digits. How many digits are there? Based on that, you will get 3 sevens. So let me see. 8 power 3, how much, ma'am?
512.
What, ma'am?
512.
Yes. 512 minus 1 will be 511. So this is in octal. This is in 172. This is in octal. This is in hexadecimal. Convert this decimal to octal and tell me the answer. Try to understand, ma. Previous ga 2 power 4 annappudu manaku em ochindi 16. So this representation is in decimal. In the same way, whenever you are having a powers, the resultant will be in decimal. Convert that decimal to octal. What we will get? Chesnara? ఏం వస్తుంది అమ్మా 511 డెసిమల్ ని ఆక్టల్ కన్వర్ట్ చేస్తే 777 yes yes only one student in the class ah huh? What we will get if you convert a decimal number 511 to octal
777
yes 777 so 777 minus 172. Okay, so our main intention is when we come here whether we are getting 777 or not. So in the same way for hexadecimal, what we will get, ma?
15
we will get. Okay, so now let me go for the previous example. In this way you have to calculate for decimal chudama. Okay, we will see the decimal. So for decimal, what we will get?
999
we will get. Okay, now let me start. Let me show R minus 1's complement. We calculated previously for binary. For which number, ma? A number ki calculate jaisa 1101.
0101.
మనం మైనస్ 111 చేస్తే ఏమొచ్చింది రిజల్ట్? 0010. Right? So whatever that I explained until previous will not be given any explanation directly. Ones complement means maximum of them will explain like ones complement is converting 1 to 0, 0 to 1. So the given binary number is 1101. You try to take 11. So here we have a 1. The other one is 0. If it is 1, the representation of that will be 0. If it is 0, the representation means 1. So converting 1 to 0, 0 to 1. If we are having 1, convert that to 0. If we are having 0, convert that to 1. If you are having 1, convert that to 0. That is your result. We got the same result. Yes? So how to do internally? how to do internally? Simply use a NOT gate. Simply use a NOT gate. The binary number for 1101, in order to get this number complement, let us consider this is B. In order to get B's complement of that, what we will do is we will apply this to NOT gate. This is your representation of NOT gate. We will apply this to NOT gate. So what is NOT gate mean? Given a 1, the result you will get as 0. Given a 0, the result you will get as, this is your NOT gate. So here, given an input 1, if you apply to NOT gate, you will get 0. 1, you will get 0. 1 means you will get 1. 1 means you will get 0. So this is your answer. So we know that converting 1 to 0, but internally system uses which gate in order to do this complements? System uses NOT gate for implementing this ones to zeros and zeros to ones. This is your NAR minus 1's complement. Now, we got this number for this result, we got this answer called 0010. Next is what? We have two representation. What are those two complement representation? One is R minus 1's complement and we have R's complement. Radix implementation is there and diminished implementation is also there, right? So now if I want to calculate R's complement, what I have to do? I want to calculate R's complement. Just now I have given what I have to do in order to convert this number to R's complement. Anyone?
Adding one
to not the above number, adding one to the result generated from one's complement. This is the result that we got for after completing one's complement. This is the result. So if you add plus one, the result that we will get is 2's complement. This is your 2's complement. Okay, so 2's complement means what we will get? 1 1 0